Okay, so hopefully you've seen the wonderful version of the ring cycle that I did with my son, daughter, and grandson's toys. I didn't include any music because it would have been really difficult to do, and there's just so much music. I mean, bear in mind the ring is four operas, and each of those operas is about 4 or 5 hours long. So this is an intense amount of stuff that Wagner did, on top of all the other operas he'd composed. But I did want to play a little bit of the music for you just so you get a sense of it. These are just some kind of random excerpts of parts that I liked. First of all, the very opening, the prelude to Das Rheingold, is just an incredible piece of music. I'm going to start it out here, and you're not going to hear anything for a while. Very softly. Yeah, Wagner was trying to out Beethoven. Beethoven. I mean, to heck with the beginning of the Ninth Symphony. This just goes on and on, gradually leading you in. What's being depicted is the soft undulating of the Rhine in the sunlight, with the Rhine maidens frolicking below. I mean, to heck without Beethoven, Beethoven, this is like out Philip Glassing, Philip Glass, the contemporary composer. We'll talk about him later in the term. But this just goes on. I'm going to run ahead. Builds up. Builds up. Builds up. And that's the whole prelude. It's just 5 minutes of this incredible, just kind of arpeggiating, beautiful chord over and over and over again. It's a remarkable passage of music, especially for the mid-1800s. All right, let me play a bit more. We talked about leitmotifs. Here is a really famous one that Wagner wrote for the second of the operas. The Valkyrie. This is the ride of the Valkyrie, when Brunhilde comes in to rescue, but she doesn't really. Sigmund, here we go. Again, I'm sure you've probably heard that before. You know, in any given war scene where helicopters are flying in, you know, you're going to hear this music. It's incredible piece of music. That's also a good example of those Wagner tubas that I talked about. You know, he invented these new instruments to play this music. Now, what happens with this is that as he kind of, you know, as the scene unfolds, Brunhilde comes in with her friends, the Valkyries, and she's calling to them to join her, and you'll hear her in this particular excerpt. This is part of that same Ride of the Valkyries music.
Thank you.
So in a lot of productions, I think written into the original stage directions was like Brunhilde and these Valkyrie come flying in literally. So they like suspend these women on these ropes and they'd go like penduluming back and forth across the stage. I even have one recording somewhere where you can hear the panning going back and forth when she's going, "Toyo!" It's pretty amazing. And it's quite a spectacle to see. A lot of contemporary productions don't quite do that, but yeah, it's kind of fun. And then finally, the part where Brunhilde is taken up and placed in the magic fire. There's a very famous leitmotif of the magic fire, and this is what it sounds like. Tell you. Okay, so we're going to talk about Wagner himself and his life and the problems associated with it in our next class. I'll see you all then.